Action. I have my front skirt drape here. I haven't trued it up yet. I like to wait until I've done my back. But our objective with this flared skirt and is to have the grains match at the side seam. So they should be at the same angle. That gives us a balance in the amount of flare in the front and the back. So there's different ways you can approach it. I could just drape my entire back and then bring them both to the table and adjust. Or I could cheat a little bit and mark the angle of this side seam on my back skirt block of muslin, and that'll guide me when I'm draping. So that's what I'm gonna do. I've got my back block torn and pressed and prepared. If you're curious how big this is, it's about 33 inches long by 25 or so inches wide. Center back marked. I've got a cross grain marked, and I'll just sort of match these centers up here and match my cross grains, and then find that side. So up here in the hip area, there could be some fit, but down below the hip, it should be straight. And I can even just kind of dash mark that. Now, I can't exactly just copy this because my side seam is probably not going to land there. But as long as it's parallel, we're good, because the back is usually not the same width as the front. So let's go to the dress form and drape in our back. Just gonna get that out of the way for a moment while I secure my center back. Okay. When I did my straight skirt, I left my front on the dress form. So if you're paying attention, you'll notice that I'm not doing that with this one, since I had to take the front off to get that angle. I'm just going to leave it off for now. I'll put them together here in a moment. Okay, I'll start the same way I did with my front, kind of working, smoothing over until the point where I think there is a flute to start. So if I shoot for the same general area, you know, over here, just to the other side of the princess, which maybe is about there, I will clip there. Let me get over here. And just like before, let it drop. And I can look both at the amount of flare I'm putting into the flute, and I can also start to look at my guideline here for the side seam, getting that perpendicular to the floor. So hold that about there for the moment. I will give it my 1/8 inch pinch. Okay, before I mark anything, I'm going to go on and check my plumb line against those marks. So the side seam of the dress form is actually here. So you can see how the back skirt is not as wide as the front skirt, which is normal. I'm just looking to see that this guideline is parallel to my plumb line, and it's not. It's got a little bit too much flare going in there. I need to bring it out about like that. So I'm lifting my cross grain a little bit. Let's secure that again. Still need to lift. Just a little. So as I lift, I actually end up pushing some more into the waist here. So then I'll have to just pull everything sort of straight over. So let me undo that. And one more check. That's where I want it to be. Okay. We'll mark it and then check everything on the table. So I'm marking to the front side of my side seam here at the hip. And then I can pretty much just go parallel to those marks, hopefully. There's my rung. my waist marked in. I was at the bottom of the tape on the front, so I should stay at the bottom of the tape on the back. That feels low. It is low.